Good afternoon and welcome to Alumni Gymnasium at Rider University. Alongside Matt Blum, I'm Josh Belcher, and we're set here for pregame coverage for the Rider Bronx taking on the Marist Red Foxes. Matt, what are your keys to the game?
I think there's a lot of keys to the game. I think for Marist, they need to get into the game quick, get a quick start, get scoring points because they're an 0-5 team right now. And the only way they're going to get to beat a team like Rider, who's 5-3, is to get off to a quick start, get the baskets in. And looking at their roster, you know, their junior guard, Dewan Goodwin, who had 18 points, 3 rebounds, and 3 assists last game, is going to be a huge integral part of their game. They also have a freshman guard, Rob Johnson, who's been getting some good playing time, 13 points, 4 rebounds last game. And I think for Ryder, the main thing is going to be staying out of foul trouble.
Yes.
You've seen that their lineup has changed from the beginning of the season. Jermaine Jackson is no longer starting because he's been getting in foul trouble a lot. He only had 11 minutes last game, opposed to about 30 minutes the last couple games. I think Ryder going to a three-guard set is going to change the dynamic of how they play with Justin Robinson, Jamar Youngblood, and Ryan Thompson starting at those three guards, and then having the two forwards is going to be a different flavor. So we'll see how that works out.
As for my prediction of the game, I see Ryder hopefully jumping out to a quick lead. If they're able to do that and sustain that and not, you know, let up at all, I see Ryder with a double-digit win, coasting to an easy victory. First conference game.
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, they're going against an 0-5 Marist team. You don't want to discount them at all, but at the same time, I think that, you know, Ryder is a good enough team where they can pull it through, and I think we're going to see a win for Ryder today.
All right. We'll be right back with starting lineups and tip-off. Welcome back to Alumni Gymnasium. Alongside Matt Blum, I'm Josh Feltry. We're a minute away from tip-off here, Matt. What are you looking for in the beginning of the game?
I'm looking for Ryder to come out strong, come out quick, score. They always do this, so I want to see them come out strong like they always do and just start scoring quickly. I mean, they're playing an 0-5 Marist team, but you don't want to let that 0-5 record speak for the team completely because records aren't everything always. A lot of teams will come in and get a quick win just because the other team's not expecting them. So we're gonna wait and see how Ryder can deal with that. And also Marist, I was talking to some of their players before the game. They're looking to come out strong after a tough loss last game against Fairfield, and they want to come out strong. So I would expect them to come out the same way, scoring quickly, trying to get the ball in the hoop. So we'll see how it works out for them.
Yeah, and Ryder is looking for their third win in a row after beating Binghamton and St. Joe's at home. St. Joe's is a very big game, televised. This is just set up for a letdown right now for Ryder. They got to make sure they come out strong.
Exactly. For Marist has nothing to lose right here. They're already 0-5. Ryder has a lot to lose at a 5-3 record trying to get to the NCAA tournament. They need to make sure that they don't lose this game, because if they lose this game, it could be a huge, it could be a very big just loss to their self-esteem and it's just important they don't lose the game is generally what I'm trying to say.
Okay, let's turn it over to the PA announcer now for the starting lineups and national anthem.
Alumni Gymnasium, home of Rock Basketball. Today, the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference team, Ryder hosts the Red Foxes of Marist College. At this time, we would ask everyone please rise and join our players and coaches in honoring America and celebrating its freedom and those who protect it. Let us rise as one nation, one people for the singing of our national anthem. Performing the anthem today is freshman arts administration and music major Jasmine Adams.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed as
and Garland, a 6'4 freshman from Topsail, North Carolina. Number 21, Candy Brucey. Annette Garland, a 6'3 freshman from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Number 25, Sam Prescott. There is this coached by Chuck Martin.
Starting for Marist, number 11, Dewan Goodwin, number 21, Candon Rusin, number 25, Sam Prescott, number 31, Rob Johnson, and number 41, Corey Bauer. And for Ryder, number 15, Justin Robinson, number 5, Ryan Thompson, 23, Novar Gadsden, number 2, Mike Ringgold, and number 3, Jamar Youngblood. As we get ready for tip-off.
Hey guys, I'm Katie Blakeman, and I'm here at the Bronx Zoo waiting for the tip-off. Mike Ringgold and Corey Bauer at center court, ready to get it started. Let's send it back down to the action on the court.
You know, it'd be interesting to see how Brewer matches up with Ringgold. It'd be an interesting matchup to see, I think.
And Marist wins the tip in the away red, Ryder in the home white. Goodwin at the top of the key, swings it over to Rusin. Swings it again. Back to Goodwin at the top of the key. Back again to Johnson at the top. Goodwin at the top of the key again as Marist initiates their offense. Robinson guarding Goodwin at the top of the key, swings it to Rusin into the corner. Prescott dribbles it out, back to Johnson. Marist looks a little bit lost here in the beginning of the game. Johnson, three, very bad shot, air ball.
And I think there was some miscommunications there in that opening drive by Marist there.
Novar getting the ball in the wing, swings it over to Ryan. Ryan drives and draws the foul on the floor.
And it looks like Marist right now is getting a huddle with their team just to get on the same page. It looks like they're all a little off.
Straight.
Yeah, because you know they threw that air ball up quick. So,
okay, Thompson inbounding the ball. Up to Robinson, top of the key, swings it to Youngblood. Back to Robinson, over to Novar. Oh, nice pass to Youngblood. Kicks it back out to Danson, 4-3, a little short. Rebound Bauer, out to Goodwin, runs it up the floor. Goodwin drives, hands it to Prescott. Johnson, I'm sorry. Prescott swings it over to Rusin. Back to Johnson, and back to Goodwin to the other side of the floor. Goodwin drives, steps back. Good defense by Ringgold right there.
I like to see him playing close on his man like Thompson's doing right now. Just not letting him
get in.
Very
good defense by Ryder. Tough shot, a little off. Bauer, offensive rebound, but stolen by Gadsden. Ryder has numbers here. Justin Robinson drives, kicks it out to Jamar Youngblood. Called by traveling. That was close.
And it looks like that was a quick. Youngblood was trying to go for the three, but I think he was thrown off a little bit when his man from there. So
yeah, I think
throw somebody off pretty quick there.
Ryder in full court pressure here as Rusin sets inbound the ball. Looks like Ryder's going to do a full court trap. Marist breaks pretty easily. Bauer down low, gets stripped. Prescott with the putback. Maris comes back with a pressure of their own. Ryder breaks it easily. Justin Robinson down the lane, blocked by Bauer.
It looks like I was saying before the pregame, Maris is really trying to come out quick and get those points on the board, which they've done, going with a quick-paced offense.
Yeah, right now,
I think at first they were a little bit confused on what they were doing. That's why you saw them take that air ball and not make as many shots.
One for three. Good. Normally he's a spark plug off the bench, but Tommy Dempsey, the head coach of the Bronx, inserted him a couple games ago.
Yeah, and I think that's been a huge advantage for the Bronx because, like I said, you know, Jamar Youngblood plays, even though he is a shorter player at 6'1", he plays like a big man. He has some incredible hops, and he reminds me a lot of Allen Iverson, a type of guard who's not afraid to drive to the hole.
Prescott for three, long. Rebound goes to Gadsden. Gathers himself, gives it to Thompson. Back to Gadsden, 4-3. Ooh, way off the mark.
That was a rare miss by Navarre Gadsden. I mean, you see Ryder's such a good three-point team. They really use that to their advantage. So it was surprising there to see Gadsden miss that because he's usually pretty on point with those.
He's been shooting the ball well so far this season.
I mean, he had a couple games ago where he went 4-for-4 from beyond the arc and just shooting really well.
Goodwin breaks the double team. Prescott goes to the middle of the lane, pulls it back out. Back to Goodwin at the top of the key. Maris will initiate their offense once again. Let's see if they can actually get something here on the set offense.
And it looks like Maris' approach right now is just trying to take it slow to kind of catch Ryder off guard for those quick Goodwin drives like Goodwin's doing right now.
Called for a carry. And here comes both teams, full court pressure here early.
I think they're both putting that precedence out there that they're not going to play soft, and both teams need this win. I mean, like I said before in the pregame, Ryder cannot afford to lose a game to an 0-5 Maris team.
Especially in conference. You don't want to start off conference play with a loss. As
exactly, especially to Maris.
Youngblood swings it to Thompson. 4-3. A little short. Bauer with the defensive rebound. Gives it to Goodwin. Swings it to Rusin and swings it to the corner. Prescott. Looks like he wants to pass. Passes it to Johnson, top of the key, back to Goodwin. A lot of perimeter passing going on here so far for Marist.
Yeah, like I was saying, they're trying to slow the game down, I think, and take some time off, because we're already at 16:30, and it's only a 3-2 game right now.
Yeah, it's a defense-oriented game right now.
It's more, I think they're trying to set up a good...
No good, air ball.
I think both teams are trying to set up a defensive force just for both teams.
Thompson kicks it out to Robinson. 4-3. Good. Bottom of the net for Robinson.
And that was Maris' big flaw right there. They really need to play tight on, especially on Ryder at the three-point line, because they're so dangerous from beyond the arc.
Bauer swings it to Rusin in the corner. Rusin trying to drive. Lost the ball out of bounds. Another Maris turnover. Right now it seems like it's a very defense-oriented game. Both teams are sloppy. It looks like they're rushing.
And like I'm saying, they're taking a quick timeout, and I think they want to get... I think main thing for Maris right now is they're trying to get back on the same page. I think they started off the game very confused, not knowing their game plan very well. You saw them take a quick air ball. Their defense isn't where it should be, I don't think. And you see that mainly in their gameplay so far. So
yeah, we'll see what happens if the full court pressure is staying. Cause so far, neither team has had a problem breaking it.
And, like I said, it's important that they're both trying to establish that quick, the tough defense in the beginning so that they don't want to give up any points. And you can see by the score 6-2 right now that both teams are playing tough defense. The Ryder, again, like I was saying, so dangerous beyond the arc. They can't afford to leave them open like that. And even when they did leave them open, Justin Robinson had a man in his face, but he was still making the three. So when you see that play out in various forms.
The Ryder right now, as you can see, is live and died by a three all season. They made two. I think, what did they miss two as well? So right now they're getting a lot of threes. We'll see if they're able to drive and try to get something in the lane when they come back out.
And you've seen this ever since they took their center Jermaine Jackson out of the lineup and started Youngblood as a three-guard set. You've seen that since they've done that. They've been more of a three-point shooting team, more of a perimeter offense team, not as much working it in. They have Ringgold and Gadsden down low. And they're both big men, and they play big. And like I said before, Youngblood can play big. So we'll see how that plays out.
In the game, box number 12, Jonathan Thompson.
And the only only substitution made for Ryder is now number 12 is in Jonathan Thompson.
And I like to see Jonathan Thompson in the game. He's been playing some big minutes as a freshman. He's been playing a lot of minutes. He's a great energy player off the bench. He's a high flyer. He can shoot the three. He does a lot for Ryder.
It's interesting move taking Justin Robinson off the floor, though. You're limiting yourself to not as many ball handlers.
I think they want a bigger man in there and want to rest him. So
Jamar passes up the three. Swings it to Ringgold in the corner. Ringgold dribbles out to Novar. Top of the key. Nice pass to Youngblood. Ringgold picks it up, puts it up. No good. Gets his own rebound, puts it back up, and in. That's effort right there. That's hard.
And you'll see that Ringgold will make a lot of those shots under the basket. You know, it's interesting. He'll miss a lot of easy shots, but make some of the most ridiculous shots. You know, it's beyond me, but
his game may not be the prettiest, but he gets it done.
He gets his points in.
Goodwin stuck, passes down low to Bauer, who has a size advantage. No good on the jump hook. Gadsden with the rebound.
I think one of Ryder's disadvantages here, they don't have a true center. That's why they've been playing either the two guard three forward or three guard two forward sets.
Thompson down low to Ringgold on the post. Pump fakes, goes down low. Nice lefty hook right there by Ringgold.
And you see, Ringgold's their closest thing right now on the court to a center. He plays a very hybrid style offense, where he can shoot the three, he can play the outside game, but it can also play inside, almost like a Dirk Nowitzki, if you will.
Goodwin at the top of the key, passes over to Prescott. Prescott tries to drive, good defense by Thompson. Goodwin at the top of the key, and we have a foul on, looks like, Novar Gadsden holding. And with Mike Ringgold, him being low post opens up the three.
Exactly, it opens that up because they're going to have to commit more men down low. So that's a huge advantage for Ryder to have with Mike Ringgold. And they're bringing in Brandon Penn right now, who's also another force that's very similar. He's more of a low post offense guy, but he also can shoot that three if he's wide open.
Marist inbounds the ball. Taylor also in now for Marist. As Marist made some substitutions, Taylor and now, let's see, Kaba is also in number 5. Goodwin at the top of the key. Swings it over to Taylor. Looks like Ryder's in a 2-3 now. Switch to zone defense out of the inbounds play. Goodwin, fadeaway jumper. Little long. Penn skies for the rebound.
And I think that was smart by Ryder going with the zone defense there, with Corey Brewer out.
Thompson, no call there. Should have been a charge or a block, one of the two. But Maris gets defensive rebound. Rusin takes it to the hoop. Acrobatic layup missed. Put back made by number 1, Dorvell Carter, also in the game for Marist. So Marist's bench come in, giving them a spark as there's still full court pressure right now. Thompson crosses half court, back to Ryan Thompson. Ringgold gets it, drives to the lane, throws up. I guess that's a shot.
Yeah, I think he saw number 1 there.
Up from there, we have Marist stepped out of bounds. Another turnover for Marist.
It looks like Justin Robinson's coming back in. So there, I think that Ryder looks a little bit confused. They want to give Jamar Youngblood some time on the bench to sit and rest, get his legs back under him. And now going with a more, like I said before, almost with Jonathan Thompson in there, that almost creates even a hybrid version of the three guard, two forward, because he Marist can play forward or guard.
Marist is now also in a 2-3, which is interesting with those shooters. Robinson gets it. Ringgold down low in the paint, wide open, lefty shot, no good. And a foul on Ringgold, it looks like.
It looks like Marist is playing a little monkey see, monkey do here. You know, they see Ryder come out in the full court pressure. They come out in the full court pressure. They see Ryder in the 2-3 zone. They come out in the 2-3 zone. I think they want to match, almost like a chess game. They want to match every move.
It looks like neither team can get in a rhythm because of the defenses. They're switching it up.
Exactly. I mean, it's working out in Ryder's favor right now, being that it's 10 for them. But, you know, I think Marist is waiting for Ryder to make a mistake, and that's when they're going to try to capitalize to get some points on the board.
Carter swings it to Goodwin on the top of the key. He has Ringgold on him. That's a mismatch. Good defense by Ringgold. Tough shot by Goodwin off the glass.
And Ringgold, that wasn't Ringgold's fault there. I think Goodwin just had some amazing offensive shots there. I mean, you can only do so much. You can put your hand in their face, but sometimes the shots just fall for people.
John Thompson has the ball knocked out of bounds. Still Ryder ball underneath the hoop. As the score is 10-6 now, with 12:27 left to play here in Olin Ryan Gymnasium. Looks like Ryan Thompson's going to inbound the ball. A sub. We have Dara and Azuma coming in for Mike Ringgold.
It's interesting to see that because Azuma's their bench player who's the closest they have to a real center on the team, I'd say. I mean, he plays like a center, but he also, I mean, he's telling me he's a smaller guy.
Thompson,
he can only start
three. Real short. Cabo with the rebound immediately races up the floor. Wisely pulls it out as Marist did not have numbers. Long on the three for Marist. Azuma with the rebound.
You see Azuma there, like I was saying before, he's so long and he's a tall guy. He's at 6'10", 6'11".
He's in there for defense and rebounding.
Exactly. He's not a huge point scorer, but he's trying to get the ball in the post there, as you see.
Yeah, he's got a big height advantage right there.
He hasn't seen much playing time, but
Robinson drives, kicks out Thompson, swings it to Penn. Penn drives, gives it down to Azuma down low, who goes up, blocked. Paris with the rebound.
And I see a bright future for Azuma. Once he gets some more weight on him, I think he'll be a much better post player.
He's
right
Paris
now.
Right now. This is a mismatch right now. Kaba gets the ball, guarded by John Thompson. Swings it over to Paris. Good defense by Ryder so far. Price gets the ball in the corners. An offensive foul taken by Azuma. It's the energy we were talking about.
Exactly like we were saying.
And we'll be back in a little bit as an official timeout on the floor. Gymnasium with 11:26 to go in the first half. The Ryder Bronx are leading Marist Red Foxes 10-6 in Ryder's first conference game of the season. Ryan Thompson dribbles the ball at the top of the key. Swings it to John Thompson. Back to Ryan. Looks like Marist is still in a 2-3 zone as they swing the ball. Ryder swings the ball around the perimeter. Into Penn in the corner. Tries a skip pass. Take gotten by Azuma. Swings it. Ball swung to Robinson. Skip pass over to Penn. This is good defense right now by Marist. Robinson gets the ball, takes an NBA three from the top of the key, and it's good! A deep three from Robinson.
And again, Justin Robinson just showing his range there with that very long three with the man in his face. That's the second three. He's 6 points already.
Communication on Marist's part as Price throws the ball out of bounds looking for Cabo.
And Robinson almost has half the team's points right now.
It's interesting how he comes in off the bench and immediately has an impact after taking a seat for a little while.
And that's the kind of play you'll see from Justin Robinson. Some really good shot selection, some very long range. He's a very good shooter in general.
Robinson gets the ball, drives into the lane, swings it out to Ryan Thompson for three. Short. Penn with the offensive rebound, puts it back up, also short. And we have a foul on the floor, and it looks like Marist.
Looks like it's on number zero, Price.
Fouls on number five, Cabo. Fouls have not been an issue so far for either team.
And that's good to see that Ryder's had that trouble in the past couple games with their foul trouble.
John Thompson gets it out front and travels with it. We've seen a lot of travels here today.
That is a big thing. I've seen Youngblood had a travel on the drive earlier, and you just had Jonathan Thompson travel. I mean, it's interesting you see that. I mean, you usually don't see that big of a problem, especially in college games.
Cabo gets the ball in the corner, double teams. Turnover. Ringgold comes up with a steal. Thompson looks up for as he's going. Hands the ball off to Robinson, swings to Ringgold. Swings it to John Thompson. Back to Ringgold. Jonathan Thompson, Justin Robinson. Back to John Thompson. Ringgold gets the ball, drives. Layup off the glass. Strong move by Mike Ringgold.
And Ringgold playing an intricate part of this team right now. He's really stepping it up. Just doing everything. That's a 6 point off starting out.
Ooh. Paris lost the handle there. Ryder has numbers. Alley-oop to Ringgold. Lays it in. We have a timeout by Chuck Martin, Marist's head coach. Looks like that's a 30-second timeout.
And it looks like that was a good call by Maris. Call that timeout to stop everything and get together.
And we're back, and Piers Maris has inserted Goodwin back into the lineup. They've gone very deep into their bench very early into this game right now.
Yeah, you've seen a lot of guys come off the bench. There's only maybe been two players who haven't seen action yet, and likewise for Ryder. But again, they're short with three players on the bench today. Pat Mansell and Carl Johnson are both not playing today.
Prescott gets the ball, drives down the middle. Left-handed layup, rims out. Novar gets him with a rebound. Oh, but Prescott gets the steal off the board and puts it up. Heady play right there.
Very good awareness by Prescott there. You know, seeing that he missed a shot and Gadsden wasn't paying attention, he stole it real quick.
Maris stole this 2-3. Ryder really hasn't figured it out yet. Ryan Thompson swings it to Ringgold in the corner. Gets double teamed. Ringgold dribbles through it, puts it up with the left. It's a little long. Novar with the tip. No. Prescott with the rebound, gives it to Goodwin as he brings it up with four.
And I think the zone defense is throwing Ryder off a little bit. You know, it's confusing them. They're not used to seeing that. They're usually used to playing the man defense.
Tough shot right there by Prescott. He wanted a foul but didn't get it. Gadsden gets the ball in the corner. Swing pass to Robinson. Very dangerous pass right there. Ringgold down the low post. Nice move. And he'll go to the line shooting too.
And I think another reason you're seeing this zone defense from Maris and Ryder is because it eliminates the mismatches that are created. When you have a guy sitting, when you have your center and forwards playing at their center and forward spot, you're not going to get those mismatches as much. So it's going to make guys match up with guys their own size.
Ringgold's first free throw way off the mark. He's a 26% free throw shooter this year. That is not going to cut it for a Division I program. As Carter,
it's not. He really needs to work on that. But again, he'll make the really hard shots and miss the easy ones.
And we have a lane violation, it looks like, on
Ryder. It looks like Gadsden was kind of bumped into that one there.
Yeah, that you don't see that very often when it comes in college and NBA. You don't see line violations.
Replacing number 5, Ryan Thompson.
Youngblood comes in for Ryan Thompson. You know, it's not often Ryan goes to the bench, so see what happens.
I think they want to get him some rest, too, before the second half. I think we're getting halfway through almost a little bit more.
The score is 17-8 with your Ryder Bronx up ahead right now with just over 8 minutes left in the first half. Goodwin gets the ball at the top of the key. He's been quiet tonight. He led the team in scoring the last game versus Fairfield. He had 18 points, a season high.
It's interesting to see the lineup that Ryder's been going with. They have a very hybrid lineup in general.
They have a very big lineup out there. And another travel is called on Prescott for Marist.
And like I was saying, you know, the hybrid lineup they're going with is they have a lot of big guys out there, like Brandon Penn, Mike Ringgold, Navarre Gadsden, but they're all guys who are capable of, you know, dribbling the ball, taking three-pointers, and doing a lot of things that smaller guys do, and vice versa for guys like Jamar Youngblood, who are small but can do the big man things.
Gadsden gets the ball, drives, nice pass to Youngblood, who gets it stripped. Ringgold goes up and is fouled again. Mike Ringgold will go back to the line. Let's see if he can make these. But first, we have a timeout on the floor.
Official timeout. Fans, it's now time for
Garden. What did you do to prepare for the MAC?
Practice hard and just buying into what the coach is trying to explain to us. It helps us a lot during the game.
What are your expectations for today's game?
We play defense, we'll win by a lot. But if we play terrible defense like we have the past couple days, we'll be in for a nice game.
What's your strategy going into today's game?
Basically just playing hard and doing whatever it takes to win.
All right, thanks.
So what have you done to prepare for today's game?
We just went over the other team's personnel, watched a little film, and did the things that we do in practice.
And you come in as a freshman and got a lot of playing time. How do you feel about that? Like, what have you done with that?
I don't try to do too much. I just I just do what I can with my time.
Thank you, Jonathan.
So let's see if Ringgold improves that free throw percentage or makes it even worse. It's kind of hard to believe that could be worse than 26%.
And it looks like it could have the effect of icing the kicker that timeout that was just taken. You never know. Or it could give him some time to get ready for that. It's really hit or miss.
First free throw, long and to the left.
It looks like Maris might be going with the hack-a-shack type defense here. I mean, Ringgold will make some good shots under the basket, but his free throw percentage just isn't there. So maybe they're taking that approach early.
That's long as well, and Maris gets the rebound. Goodwin brings the ball up the floor. Hands it off to Rusin. Nice spin move. Kicks it out to Goodwin. Marist hasn't had a lot of easy baskets tonight.
They have not. I mean, that's because of Ryder's interior defense, I'd say. LeVar Gadsden and Mike Ringgold have been playing some very good D inside.
Prescott tries driving on Robinson. We have a foul on the floor on Justin Robinson. He looks perplexed by that call.
Yeah, I didn't really see anything there that would warrant a foul. Maybe a no call, but I mean, definitely not a foul on Robinson.
Let's see if Ryder goes into that 2-3 zone they did before out of the inbounds. And Rusin with the three, way short. But Prescott, ball stepped around. Ryan Thompson ends up with it. Brings it up to Youngblood. Ryder has no numbers. Gives it back to Ryan Thompson. 4-3. Way short. Ringgold offensive rebound. Kicks it out to Youngblood. 4-3. A little short again. Man, these
guys are interesting. I mean, they're getting a lot of open shots and just they're not falling for them right now.
That was good defense by Youngblood, but Rusin draws the foul and will shoot too.
I mean, I myself am perplexed. I mean, Ryder always seems to make those open three-pointers, and the only three-pointers they've been making are the ones with Justin Robinson being completely covered.
NBA threes.
Exactly, with man in his face.
Rusin makes the first free throw, and Bauer comes back in for Marist, replacing Johnson.
And
Carter, I'm sorry.
And you see that Marist is starting to come back. It's nine. If he makes this, it'll be 10-17, so it'll only be a 7-point game, which is good for Marist, considering that Ryder usually gets a huge lead.
And the second free throw is long by Rusin, with Gadsden getting the rebound. Thompson brings the ball up the floor. Swings it to Gadsden, who swings it to Robinson. Skip pass to Ryan. Down low to Ringgold. Lazy pass by Thompson. Stolen. Prescott brings the ball forward. Passes it to Rusin. 4-3. Short. As Gadsden ends up with a rebound. Robinson bringing it up the floor. Tries to hand off to Gadsden. Does. Gadsden goes in. Thought he got fouled, but loses it. Marist has numbers here if they hurry. Goodwin swings it out to Rusin. Swings it to Johnson. Passes it to Bauer down low. Swings it out to Prescott. Prescott hands it to Goodwin. Goodwin, 4-3. Short. Prescott, though, with the offensive rebound, through the legs of Goodwin and out of bounds.
Right, and I think ball. What we just saw will be a huge part of whether or not Marist will win, because on things on plays like that, on fast breaks, two-on-ones, they should be making those, and in which case they came away with nothing.
And so, Cabo just came in for Johnson, for Marist.
Exactly. So, you don't... I think they're trying to make some substitutions just to see what they can if they can fix that.
And Marist has a lot of fresh legs in there. They've already had five people off the bench in the game. Robinson swings it to Gadsden on the top of the key. Swings it back over to Thompson. Thompson swings it to Gadsden, who pulls up for three. Long. Rusin with the rebound, and Marist is outrunning again with numbers. But they pull it up, and Rusin ends up with a wide open three in the corner. That's long. Marist offensive rebound again.
And they're slowing it down, which isn't smart. In some situations, it'd be smart to slow the ball down. But
they just had a 4-on-2 fast break.
Exactly. And Marist, they're taking the low percentage shots and not making them. And it's one thing if you're making them, but they're not making them. So they need to.
Goodwin hands off to Rusin. Rusin drives the lane, loses the ball. Robinson ends up with it, throws it up to Youngblood. Goes up with the acrobatic layup, short, misses it. Prescott with the rebound, and Goodwin's running the other way for Marist. All the way to the hoop, another missed layup. Cabot with the offensive rebound and puts it in. Finally, someone made a bucket. And Tommy Dempsey is not pleased with his Ryder Bronx as he calls timeout.
And we'll be right back.
how are you prepared for today's game?
Over practice, we just been trying to go over their defensive zone and stuff like that, you know, just basically trying to focus on that. I mean, our offense always come through, so we just basically focus on defense.
In the past couple games, you've had some trouble with fouls and stuff. How do you plan to, like, tweak your game just so you can stay out of foul trouble?
Just stop reaching, move my feet. You know what I mean? That's basically all I can do, really. Once I do that, I'll be fine.
All right, thank you, Jermaine.
And we're back, and it's Ryder's ball after that last possession. Thompson brings the ball up the court. Thompson's been very quiet today. He has two assists, but no points. Very quiet.
Yeah. And I think a big story of this game right now is that both teams are coming out sort of flat in a way.
Alley-oop to Thompson, broken up. It's not a wise pass by Youngblood. And Jonathan Thompson is in now for Ryder. And there's a foul. Looks like it might be on Youngblood. And Maris will go to the line and shoot two.
And it is, in fact, on Youngblood. And this is another interesting thing. I usually don't see teams huddling on the court. I mean, you usually see that happen off the court, but this Maris team is really doing a lot of on-court strategizing, almost a lot of player coaching.
Number one, Dorval Carter, is on the line, and he is short on the first free throw. And free throws have been a problem for both teams thus far. And Penn comes in for Gadsden for Ryder.
I think Coach Dempsey's trying to just keep throwing guys in the rotation and see what works, because right now both teams are flat, like I said. I mean, Ryder, it's still 17-11. They haven't scored in a few minutes.
That free throw's off as well as Penn grabs the rebound. Gives it to Thompson, who dribbles up the court. Swings it to Penn, swings it over to Thompson on the near side. Back to Penn at the top of the key. Looking for someone to pass to, finds Youngblood next to him. High post, back out to Youngblood. Ryder is not getting much penetration. Settle for a long three again, missed by Penn. And Paris ends up with a rebound for Maris, as Ryder is not looking good offensively.
And you saw some really good awareness there by Ryan Thompson. I mean, Ryder didn't get the ball back, but you saw him try to tip it, get it to his teammates, but it just didn't pan out.
Taylor ends up wide open. Kaba wide open in the corner for three. Long. Jonathan Thompson ends up with a rebound, running up court, throws it to Youngblood, who lays it in for two.
And do you see what Youngblood just did? He twisted his body midair.
Doing some body control right there.
A mix between Kobe Bryant, Dwayne Wade, a lot of guys just doing that twisting move and getting that basket in. I mean, he does some very acrobatic things.
Paris gives the ball to Goodwin in the corner. And we have a moving screen set by Paris. And we are the under four timeout right now. So right now, the score is 19-11, just under 4 minutes left.
And you know, I think if Ryder wants to ensure this win, they need to come back out and get a lot of points on the board, get the score back up, because, you know, Maris is coming back, and, you know, they've only scored once just right now by Jamar Youngblood in the last, I'd say, 3 minutes. They've had only one score, so if Ryder wants to ensure this victory, they need to really get back on the offensive game.
Yeah, right now, you know, Maris' goal right now is to keep this game within 10 at halftime, get into halftime with a single-digit deficit so they can make some noise in the second half. Ryder, on the other hand, is trying to get that thing up to 15, trying to make some shots and get some turnovers.
And if you're Maris right now, you're doing a great job relatively to what you're playing against. When you're an 0-5 team playing against a team like Ryder, who's a very powerful offensive scoring team, you're going to be happy with the score that's going right now, because, I mean, you'd ideally like to be winning, but at the same time, you know, they're playing very good defense, keeping Ryder somewhat out of the game, somewhat on their heels, not as in sync as they'd like them to see, as you'd like to see them be.
Yeah, right now Ryder's taking a ton of perimeter shots and not really hitting any of them at all. Besides Robinson, everyone else is cold from the field right now, so they need to try taking it to the rim and maybe going to the free throw line.
And I think I'd like to see that lineup back with Azuma, and then they had more of a traditional lineup, but they had Azuma at the center position. They had Brandon Penn at the power forward position. Then they had Jonathan Thompson at small forward, and Ryan Thompson and Jamar Youngblood at guard, or Justin Robinson at guard. I think that was working well well for them because it was a more traditional lineup, as you'd see.
Yeah, right now in for Ryder is Brandon Penn, Mike Ringgold, Jonathan Thompson, and Ryan Thompson.
And you're seeing a similar variation of that with Ringgold and Penn playing those bigger positions where they go with a Jonathan Thompson's a very much small forward type player. He can shoot the three, but he also, you know, plays a lot of guard.
And Marist is back in that 2-3 zone with Goodwin, Rusin, Prescott, Bauer, and Kaba on the floor. Swings the ball to Penn. Back to Youngblood at the top of the key. Swings it over to Thompson. They're getting nothing inside against this 2-3 zone. Ryan Thompson gets the ball on the wing. Brings it back out. Swings it to Jonathan Thompson. Freshman seeing a lot of playing time so far. Ryan gets the ball. Skip pass over to Brandon Penn. Swings it back to Ryan. Ryan trying to drive. Puts up a shot. Little long. Ball goes out of bound. It will be to Marist.
And again, you know, Marist doing a good job with this defense. They're really not giving Ryder a lot of opportunities, if any. You know, Ryder's a big three-point team, and they're defending them very well and not being able to get the ball inside because they don't have any huge guys in there like Jermaine Jackson or, you know, Dare Azuma.
And Ryder picked up full court man-to-man right there to give Marist a different look, and they got by easily. Prescott with the ball. Swings it to Goodwin. Bauer really wants the ball inside and is calling for it. They can't seem to get it into him. Goodwin gets the ball. Prescott, top of the key. Dribbles around. Marist has been very stagnant with their offense today. Prescott drives, and we have a foul on the floor, looks like, on Youngblood.
That's Youngblood's second foul pretty quick, and they looks like they're bringing in Justin Robinson to replace him. I mean, you don't want to have, you know, the similar story that's been going on most of the season where you get in foul trouble early. That's been a huge problem for Ryder this year.
Ryder with six team fouls, and same with Maris. So next time each team gets a foul, it'll be in the 1-1. Price now in for Maris, has the ball at the top of the key. Calls out a play, instructing players around. Prescott gets the ball. Kaba flashes the high post, but doesn't get it. Back to Rusin. Both teams just moving the ball around the perimeter, getting nothing inside. As Ryder is also in a 2-3.
It looks like Maris is just getting just as perplexed as they are, but
deep three. Off the mark for Price.
And Price, it was running down there with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. He had to kind of just jack that up. I mean, you know, you don't see much from the coach because the coach knows that was, you know, what had to happen.
And there was a loose ball foul on Bauer, and now there'll be a 1-1 with Mike Ringgold back to the free throw.
And again with the Hack-A-Shack.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea. Just they might get the ball back right here.
And go for a 2-for-1 situation where they can get back into this game before the half.
And Ringgold does not get the roll. A little bit long, as the crowd is very displeased.
That was the closest he's gotten all night with the free throws. So
Cabo swings the ball to Price. Price at the top of the key. Prescott. Swings it out to Cabo. We have a traveling violation on Prescott. I think that's the fourth traveling violation so far in the first half.
And I think that Maris is a bit confused on what to do as far as a game plan to get back in this. They don't know really how to score. It's, yeah, exactly. It's very individual. They're not playing as a team right now.
Ryan trying to swing the ball, goes to Penn on the far side. Ryan gets it, swings the ball to Jonathan, back to Justin Robinson for three in the corner. A little short. And Penn gets called for a loose ball foul. And Marist will be shooting 1-1.
This is an interesting game. You know, it's very low scoring so far.
Still 19-11.
Yeah, 19-11 with under 2 minutes, exactly. You don't usually see this from Ryder, especially. You usually see, you know, 35, 45 point halves.
Cabo is at the line, shooting 1-1 for Maris. And the first one is good. You really have to take advantage when you get to the free throw line. That's 3 points right there that you can't afford to give away.
Exactly. It's sort of like in football. You have to capitalize when you're in the red zone. And right now, Maris is in the red zone with free shots. They got to make these.
And he makes both of them.
And now it's a six-point game, you know.
19-13.
Maris is just back in this.
Full court. Ryder breaks it pretty easily. Penn gets the ball on the near side, swings it to Justin Robinson, over to Jonathan Thompson, who gives the ball to Ryan Thompson. over in the corner of the pen. Skip pass to Ryan. Very poor choice of pass right there. And Maris just throws the ball down on the other side of the court, and it'll be Ryder's ball.
I think they were just throwing up a prayer there, literally and figuratively, just trying to get to anybody to get on that fast break score to get back in this, because they've been atrocious on their fast breaks tonight, giving up a lot of easy points, not making it.
Robinson on the near side, swings at the pen at the top of the key over to Jonathan Thompson. Robinson gets the ball inside. Nice move off the glass for Justin Robinson.
That was a beautiful move by Robinson there, getting in, penetrating the defense with three men in that area.
It appears like there's a mix-up for Ryder, what defense they're playing, but they end up getting a turnover. Ringel with the steal. Dribbles the ball. You don't want him dribbling there, and he turns it over.
And good offensive awareness, or defensive awareness by Price there, seeing that they were going to Thompson there, but a bad pass also.
A guard needed to take that away from Ringgold. He should not be doing a fast break on his own. Price forces up a shot. Jonathan Thompson gets the ball and pushes it up. That's 40 seconds left in the first half. Nice behind-the-back dribble over to Ringgold, who misses the layup. 36 seconds left now in the first half, and Maris slows the ball down, trying to hold for the last shot of the half.
And I think the misses that Ringgold's been experiencing at the free throw line has really gotten to his head and made him shoot cold from, you know, everywhere, just getting in his head and getting him down.
Maris is swinging the ball on the outside, holding the ball for the last shot, as the shot clock has been turned off. Ringgold out guarding Price. And a hand check now, which is the last thing Ryder wanted to do, is send him to the line for a one-on-one situation.
Because right now it's not a good distance, but a relatively good distance and score for Ryder from what they've been playing like tonight, or this afternoon, rather. And they don't want to give him any chances to get any closer because, you know, like you've seen, it's been a very low-scoring half. So we'll have to see how this works out.
If Price makes both of these free throws, it will be a 6.8, which Ryder, you can guarantee, will not be happy with in the locker room. And the first free throw from Price is good.
And I think another big part that you're not seeing today is the Ryder crowd. You know, they're a bit just flat as well as the team has been.
The team.
And when you don't have the crowd into this, it's such a big part of playing here. You're not seeing them make these shots.
And Price makes both free throws as Paris comes in for Maris, defensive replacement.
And that's very rare again. I mean, you see a guy at the free throw line, usually the crowd here is very into it.
With 10 seconds left on the clock, Ryder rolls the ball. Thompson picks it up. Has to hurry, jogging up the court. Now 6 seconds. Thompson swings at Gadsden. Puts up a prayer. A little short. No shot good on the dunk attempt by Penn. And that's it for the first half here at Alumni Gymnasium, with the halftime score being 21-15 with your Ryder Bronx ahead. And we'll be back in a little bit for some halftime coverage. I'm Josh Felcher here with Matt Blum for the halftime report. The Ryder Bronx right now are leading the Marist Red Foxes 21-15. What have we seen so far in the first half?
Josh, I've seen a lot of flat play from both teams. You know, you see Ryder not really coming out scoring explosively like they usually do. Seeing Marist, same thing. They're scoring pretty low for their standards as well. Seeing Ryan Thompson, he's gone 0-for-5 from the field with 0 points, which is, you know, very, very unlike Ryder's play style. Usually you'll see Ryan Thompson with at least 7 points by the halftime. So it's an interesting, you know, it's been a very interesting game. You see guys like Mike Ringgold's been kind of thrown off by, you know, going 0-for-4 from the free throw line. And, you know, there's just been a lot of trouble. I mean, Ryder's a very high scoring team, usually a very powerful offense. You see them scoring very low.
Yeah, right now, Ryder has taken 14 threes in the first half. They've only made 3 of them. Do you think they should keep on throwing up those threes, or would you like to see something different in the second half from Ryder?
You know, I don't think that if it all depends on what defense Maris plays. If they play that zone defense, it's going to be hard for for Ryder to get those threes, because they're going to be constantly covered. And you've seen that the two threes that Justin Robinson made were both with hands right in his face, and those are the only two he's made so far. So I'd say that Ryder should try to work the ball back into their post offensive game, because right now their three game's just not there as it usually is. So, I mean, you have to see how that works out with Ryder working that into the post.
What's your prediction for the second half? What do you see happening?
You know, I see that this game going the same way it's been going, with a slower paced offense, but also I could see that Ryder comes out a little bit more energetic, as well as Marist trying to, you know, get back in this game. So I'm seeing that, I'm still thinking that Ryder's going to win because both teams are playing flat right now. I think it's going to even out and Ryder's going to win this, but still a very low scoring game I see.
Yeah, we'll see if shots start to fall in the second half. We'll be right back when that starts.
Coach, what do you have to do to secure the win in the second half?
We have to get out in transition. We're struggling a little bit against the zone. We look really stagnant. We're shooting too many threes. We have to get out in transition and get the ball into the paint.
What are you going to do to score more points and pick up the pace of the game?
Hopefully we're going to change the pace of the game with our defense, try to capitalize on turnovers and try to get, like I said, out in transition, try to get the game moving. They're trying to slow it down. We have to get it moving.
Okay, thank you very much.
Back here in Alumni Gymnasium, the second half is set to start in 15 seconds, and I'm interested to see what coaching changes there have happened at halftime.
I'm interested to see how, Ryder comes out, what Coach Dempsey had to say to them during halftime. I'm sure it wasn't anything too pleasant. I mean, Ryder coming out with only a 6-point lead into the second half, it should be interesting to see what happens.
And there's the horn for the second half to start. Right now the halftime score is 21-15. Let's see if Ryder can build on that. And Jamar Youngblood is on the floor. He has three personal fouls, with Mike Ringgold having two.
I think it'll be very important for Youngblood to stay out of foul trouble, because if he gets into foul trouble early, that's going to be very detrimental to Ryder's basketball game plan.
On the court for Ryder, we have Youngblood, Robinson, Gadsden, Ringgold, and Thompson. For Marist is Goodwin, Rusin, Prescott, Bauer, and Johnson. And the second half is underway here at Alumni Gymnasium. Youngblood bringing the ball up for, swings it to Robinson, who swings it to Gadsden. Back to Robinson and back to Youngblood as Gadsden runs the baseline. Marist is still in that 2-3 zone that baffled Ryder. Good ball movement. Nice pass by Youngblood, but Ringgold stuck. Gadsden drives, kings it out to Robinson, open for three. Good!
And Justin Robinson's been automatic from beyond the arc tonight. That's his ninth point from beyond the arc. It's 3 3-pointers.
Rusin drives the lane, stuck. Turnover, passed it right to Mike Ringgold. Good defense there by Ryder.
And it looks like Ryder's taking a much more slow approach to this second half. You saw Ringgold there waiting to make sure that his man was open before he passed to him.
Gadsden for three. Little off the mark, but Ringgold with the offensive rebound puts it up, misses it. Bauer then with an offensive rebound, or defensive rebound, I'm sorry, and a foul on Ringgold. That will be three on Mike Ringgold. Let's see what Coach Tommy Dempsey, if he leaves him in or not.
It looks like Brandon Penn's going to come in for Mike Ringgold now. I think it's a smart move because, again, we're only a minute into the second half. You don't want to see a guy foul out early, especially a guy like Mike Ringgold, who's been very instrumental in Ryder's game the last couple
games. Still four-court pressure by Ryder. Marist breaks it easily, but he steps through the trap. Goodwin has the ball top of the key as he calls out a play. Ryder's in man-to-man defense. As Robinson's playing good defense on Goodwin. He loses control of the ball, and we have a jump ball possession arrow to Marist. It's always nice to see players get on the floor like that.
Yeah, they're showing that they really want the possession. They're fighting hard for it. They want to get back into this game. It looks like Ryder's come out very energetic, scoring, getting this lead back up to 9 points.
Here's that 2-3 zone out of the inbounds pass we've seen so far. As Johnson has the ball on top of the key. Gives it to Goodwin. Goodwin's been very quiet tonight.
Yeah, I'd expected to see a lot more from him, just being the stats from the last few games.
As Robinson almost has a steal right there, but ends up, ball goes out of bounds, possession to Marist.
And it's going to be interesting to me to see how Marist decides to play the second half, putting, seeing if they're going to go as deep into their bench as they did in the first half, or if they're going to stay with their core guys and see how that works out.
There seems to be a discussion by the referees, and Coach Chuck Martin of Marist wanted to clear that up. All right, Prescott set to inbound for Marist. Goodwin gets the ball, is wide open for three. And a little long, but Bauer gets the offensive rebound. And Marist resets. It's the last thing Ryder wants to happen is offensive rebounds, and Marist taking more time off.
You really can't allow that to happen if you're going to try to be a team that wins a lot of games.
Bauer with a nice jump hook. That was a good low post move right there by Bauer.
And I saw him in the pregame working on that post move a lot. And it's, you know, he's seeing it pay off here with all the practice he's been putting into it.
Goes down low, out to Gadsden, pump fakes. Nice pass to Penn. And there's a foul on Johnson down low. Ryder will inbound the ball from underneath the basket.
Foul with 31, Rob Johnson. That's his second personal, team's first by
that. Thompson set to inbound the ball, out to Robinson, 4-3. Good, Robinson on fire here in Alumni Gymnasium today.
And Robinson can't be stopped. That's his fourth three-pointer in this game.
You think they put a hand in his face?
Even when they do, he makes it. Very good defense by Ryder there.
Turnover. Oh, Penn got the steal, but then threw it away, trying to hit Ryan Thompson towards the basket.
Coach Tommy Dempsey looks irate there on the bench, stamping his foot down, yelling at Brandon Penn. I mean, they had the fast break there, and I think that could have been a huge spark for their offense there if they would have gotten something off there, getting the crowd back into the game as well.
That really could have been a huge momentum swinger right there. They're up 10 right now, with Bronx leading 27-17 against the Red Foxes. As Bauer lays it up, nice pass by Rusin right there. Well-executed play. Thompson passes the ball to Penn. He almost wasn't ready for that. Gadsden gets the ball. Nice crossover. Swings it to Ryan Thompson. Gives the ball to Jamar Youngblood down low. Penn out to Ryan Thompson. Thompson is not really looking for his shot that much. He's looking to distribute the ball. And a foul on the court.
Yeah, Thompson's been playing a very distributive role in this game tonight. But also shooting it, but going 0-for-5. He's just been very cold tonight. No points. You know, very, very rare showing. You'll see this by Ryan Thompson.
Thompson set to inbound. Penn wide open up top. Swings the ball to Robinson. Back to Penn. Over to Youngblood. Youngblood for three. Oh, rims in and out. Johnson with a defensive rebound. Over to Price, who swings it to Rusin. Nice pump fake right there by Rusin. Swings it over to Prescott, that looks like. And the ball ended up out of bounds. Possession to Ryder. We're seeing a lot of nice passing here in the second half, though.
A lot of good passing, like you were saying. You know, Ryder's trying to make sure they make the smart pass, as well as Maris making the smart pass to get that open look.
Swing pass to Robinson, who looks down low but turns it over. He knows he made a mistake right there as he puts his head down. Rusin gets the ball in the corner, swings it back out to Johnson. Back to Rusin, who's very close stepping out of bounds. And Price gets the ball top of the key as they reset their offense. Price and Rusin, two-man game up top. Johnson for three, short. Nice board right there by Youngblood, but then it bounces off his foot out of bounds.
It sounds like the fans are getting kind of upset here. You know, putting a lot into this game, a lot of emotion, and seeing their team just not coming through on the other end.
Carter just came in for Bauer for the Red Foxes as they inbound it. Prescott got the ball top of the key as Price comes to get it. Calls out a play as Ryder's in a 2-3 zone. Wide open for three, Prescott. That's good. Defensive breakdown right there.
And it looks like Maris is right back in this game.
5-point game.
5-point game, exactly. And Ryder is not looking happy about this at all.
They need to try getting the ball into the perimeter against this 2-3 zone. Gadsden up top on the wing. Swings it over to Robinson. Swings it to Penn in the corner. Gadsden cutting the high post, doesn't get it. Ryan Thompson, 4-3. No good. But Penn with skies for the rebound, puts it back. Nice effort right there by Brandon.
Very good body control there by Brandon Penn. Missing that first, but getting back, getting his own rebound, getting that basket in. And very good body control, making up for the mistakes he was making earlier. Again with the steal.
Penn. They have numbers here. Penn takes it all the way and misses the layup. As the crowd groans right there with displeasure. And Maris comes right back with a two. It's a four-point swing right there.
And I think that Penn should have given that ball up to Thompson there.
You know, Thompson was calling for it. He wanted it.
I think he just got a little bit confused, didn't make the decision. He wasn't sure if he was passing it or shooting it, and just ended up rimming out.
Robinson didn't have a handle. Looked like he wanted to shoot that ball. Gadsden drives to the hole. A little off the mark. Johnson ends up with a rebound. Maris can make this a one-possession game here.
And you see Coach Tommy Dempsey frustrated because he needs to leave Brandon Penn in for the fact that Mike Ringgold has fouls, and he can't afford to lose a guy like Ringgold who's been playing very well this game so far.
Nice move right there. Carter, offensive rebound, puts it back up and in. Maris right now playing with a lot of heart. Ryder needs a spark plug from somewhere. Gadsden gets the ball at the top of the key, swings it over to Thompson. The crowd's getting louder. They know they need to cheer on their Bronx. Gadsden, nice pass to Penn. And the foul, and one for Penn. Nice pass by Gadsden.
And Penn trying to get himself back into this game. Looks like they're going to take a timeout just to talk things over, get back in this.
And we'll be right back.
What did you do to prepare for the MAC?
The MAC? Well, it's the first game, so it's really important. So we just been like really focused all week, and we had a game plan, and we're going to try to see if it works today.
What are your expectations for today's game?
Well, doing every game, we want to win. So hopefully, we expect to win. And that's our expectations for today.
What's your strategy going into today's game?
Just play hard. You want to just go out. Play hard, give it our best shot every night, and hopefully we come our way with the win.
All right, thanks.
And we're back in Alumni Gymnasium with a score of 31-26. Your Bronx ahead with 14 minutes left in the second half.
So, you know, when you look at the stat sheet, it's a very interesting game right now. You know, Ryder's two big players, Navarre Gadsden and Ryan Thompson, both with 0 points right now. You know, Gadsden showing up with 6 rebounds, but Thompson's really been quiet, going 0-for-6 from the field. And you're seeing a lot of play by Justin Robinson going 4-for-5 from 3-point line with 14 points.
And Marist has 7 players that have scored already. A very balanced effort by the Red Foxes thus far. And Penn will be shooting one shot after his layup. And it rims in and out, man. Free throws are killing the Bronx right now. They have yet to make one.
And Maris keeping this a very close game, all things being fair.
Bryce up top. Ryder's extending man-to-man defense, half court. Looks like they stepped their intensity a little bit. Kaba now in the game. Swings the ball back to Price. Gadsden on Price. Price takes it to the hole. Picks it back out to Rusin. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Prescott looks up at it, drives the hoop, puts up the layup. That was way too easy for Maris to run down the clock.
He just went right through their defense like a hot knife through butter.
Youngblood brings it up, swings it up to Gadsden, over to Ryan Thompson. Back to Gadsden, back to Youngblood. Youngblood's in there, 3 fouls still. Him and Ringgold, he's on the bench.
See a lot of passing, Thompson wide open in the corner there.
Yeah, they really have to swing the ball. Gadsden for three. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
And that's Gadsden's first 3 points of the game. They're really coming out here late in the second, well not late, but in the second half. You know, already 7 minutes in, you're seeing him score for the first time. So very, very different from what you're used to seeing from Ryder's offense.
In for Ryder is Mike Ringgold, and in for Marist is DeJuan Goodwin. And maybe that's a spark plug that Ryder needed right there. They look like they're playing with a lot more intensity after that timeout.
Definitely. I think Coach said something in that timeout to get them motivated.
Goodwin brings the ball before, guarded by Robinson. Trips, but the ball ends up in Prescott's hands. Youngblood on him. Kaba takes the ball to the middle, spins, forces up a shot, a little short. The fight for the rebound ends up Kaba with the ball. Takes it to the hole again and lays it in. And Maris just wants that ball more than Ryder right now.
They're really playing hard. It's a four-point game, and you're seeing a lot of play.
Jamar Youngblood for three. Long. Tipped out by Thompson and Robinson.
That was Cabe's 6 point. You know, he's really playing into the Ryder defense, even though that he's not used to that.
Nice move by Barr. Gadsden. And one for Gadsden. Strong move after the bump fake.
Exactly. Huge play by Gadsden to try to get Ryder back into this. You know, that's now he's got 5 points. Again, like I was saying before, you know, he had 0 points for a while, and Thompson still has 0 points. So it's very not like Ryder to see this. So it's very surprising. But you're seeing Gadsden kind of getting back into his own form, coming back in here, getting a quick 5 points with a shot for six.
Paris and Taylor are now in for Maris as Gadsden will shoot his free throw. And the Ryder has made their first free throw of the game. They are now, I believe, 1-for-7 from the free throw line.
And that's a very bad stat to have. You don't want to go 1-for-7 on any type of free throw stat, just because those are free points right there. You know, you can't miss those and expect to win.
Kaba has the ball for Maris, swings it out to Goodwin, guarded by Ringgold. Loses the ball, Thompson ends up with it. Nice pass to Justin Robinson, who misses the layup. How many missed layups have we seen today by Ryder?
I think Robinson was way too concerned with the man behind him and not paying attention to the basket enough.
Paris gets the ball, drives the lane, swings it out to Goodwin. Goodwin thinks about it, then pulls it out again. Maris has done a good job pulling it out when they haven't had anything. Goodwin again, swings the ball over to Cabo. Looks inside, doesn't want to. Then shoots a fadeaway three and makes it. Wow, what a tough shot by Kaba.
Kaba's been their star player tonight for Maris, no doubt in my mind. You know, making some huge shots, coming through very big for them with 9 points now.
And it's now a four-point game as the score is 37-33 in Ryder's favor.
It looks like Ryder's got themselves into a dogfight. They really need to start putting some numbers up on the board there.
Nice move by Youngblood. Can't finish around the hoop. And we have a foul going down the other way. Let's see if that's going to be on Ringgold. No, I believe that's on Ryan Thompson right there, a push.
Ryan Thompson, that's his first personal.
And we have a timeout on the floor. We'll be right back in the gymnasium.
What are your expectations going into tonight's game?
Just to play hard, make sure everybody plays defense, and play tough throughout this game.
What do you think your role is going to be leading this team in this game?
Just be one of the older guys that's leading the team, score when I need to score, and get my players open when I need to get them open.
What's your strategy going into tonight's game?
Play a lot of defense, get a lot of transition points, and just work hard.
And what do you guys do to prepare going into your MAC conference games?
It's a lot of hard practices. I mean, we went in to this week knowing that we play a MAC game, so everybody came with a lot more intensity than we usually do. And it's a MAC time, so I mean, now it's either all or nothing.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
And we're back with 11 minutes left in the second half. And it looks like to be an exciting finish for Ryder.
Exactly, and I'm looking for Ryder to come out here and start putting some points up on the board here, because really it's only a four-point game right now with 11 minutes, and it's still a lot of time for Maris to make a comeback, especially such a close game. It's a two-possession game here.
The longer Maris stays in this, the more they believe they can win. Ryder had a chance to put him away early, but they fought back, showed a lot of resiliency here.
And you know they have to. When you're an 0-5 team, you're very desperate. You need to get a win.
Price has the ball at the top of the court as Maris has gone to their bench again. Price has the ball in the corner. Picks it by Bauer. Jonathan Thompson, the freshman, is now in for Ryder. And I believe the foul will be on John Thompson.
Shut up, Liberty Road!
Maris will inbound the ball from underneath the hoop.
Team's third.
Swings the ball over to Price. Calling out a play. Ryder is in a 2-3 zone right now. Kaba swings the ball to Paris back. Good ball movement here by Maris. Paris flashes the high post, wants it, but doesn't get it. Taylor looks at the hoop. 15 seconds on the shot clock now. Taylor gets it, swings it back to Price, pulls out another play.
I think Maris really doesn't know where they're going with this right now. It's a lot of passing.
And Bauer misses the shot. No, Gadsden with the rebound. Gadsden for three. A little short. Nice rebound by Cobber right there. Strong board.
And they had number 33 wide open down there for the fast break, but they decided not to go to him, which is very, very shocking and confusing to me.
Cobba for three. Looks a little short. Ball ends up in Taylor's hands. Another offensive rebound for Marist.
These offensive rebounds are what's killing Ryder, giving them these second chance opportunities to score points, and they're usually getting them, which is very detrimental to the team trying to win.
Price has the ball, looks to go to the hoop, throws it up, and in. It's now a one-possession game.
And without that offensive rebound, it might be still at the same point. So Ryder really needs to pick up their game.
And a correction on my part, Ryder is 1-for-6 from the free throw line. John Thompson looks to shoot, passes it to Ryan Thompson, swings it to Gadsden. Ooh, looked to move before he had that ball. Dangerous pass, and Buck goes into the backcourt to get it. 15 on the shot clock as he dribbles up. Swings it to John Thompson. Over to Gadsden. Youngboy gets it on the far side. Looks inside. Swings it. Oh, stolen by Cabo. Ryder looks lost against the 3-3 zone as Cabo goes in and lays it up. We have ourselves a tie game here, folks. And Tommy Dempsey is not happy at all as he calls a timeout.
Maris is really, their bench is going nuts. I mean, they didn't expect to come in here and be able to play this well against Ryder, which is a very big surprise for them. So, you know, they're very energetic. And the Ryder crowd is just looking very gloomy right now, very glum. They don't know what's going on with their team right now.
Look at the bench right now for Ryder. All the hands are on shoulders, heads are down. Body language is not good right now for the Bronx.
They're not expecting to come in here like this. I mean, I think that Ryder's underestimated Maris a lot and also just playing soft on them. I mean, like we were saying before the game, you can't take a chance with a team like this that's on the ropes right now at 0-5, you know, and just let them walk in here to their home gym and play this well. And also, Ryder's been playing very, very, very flat tonight, just not making their shots, not getting good passes, throwing away a lot of turnovers, and just altogether not playing very well tonight.
Yeah, Maris 2-3 zone has really got them confused. They don't know what they're doing. They're swinging the ball around, taking very bad shots, lazy passes. It looks like Justin Robinson just checked in for Jonathan Thompson, who was only in for a short while. Let's see if Tommy Dempsey is able to motivate his group of players right here. So with 8:46 here in Illinois Gymnasium, Ryder Bronx and Maris Red Foxes are tied at 37 apiece. Very low scoring game.
And you know, a big part for Maris' team has been Cabo. He's been a huge X factor, coming in here with 11 points, 9 rebounds, and you know, just playing very well. A guy you didn't expect to come in here, Cabo, just playing very well tonight for Maris.
Let's see what play the Bronx run out of that timeout as Thompson brings the ball up the floor. Maris in their 2-3 zone. Youngblood back to Thompson. Sends the ball to Robinson. Back to Thompson. Once again, a lot of movement where they can't shoot the ball.
And that's, I think that Maris has found Ryder's kryptonite.
Gadsden for three. Short again, settling for shots. Bauer with a nice rebound in traffic.
With a team like Ryder, that's such a big three-point team, that zone defense really kills their game plan because they don't have any guys that are really passing into the post to play for. So
Ringgold really needs to start getting the ball down.
Exactly.
Cobb looking for an outlet, finds one. Price gets the ball, calls out a play. Ryder just looks on their heels right now defensively. As Price shoots a deep three, a little short. Nice rebound by Gadsden. As he dribbles it up the floor. Swings it to Thompson, back to Gadsden, over to Robinson.
Looks like they have Youngblood wide open in the corner.
Yeah, they haven't been looking at him. There's Ringgold down low. Just throws it up the basket. That's a bad shot.
Very bad shot selection by Ringgold there.
Taylor
wide open. Tommy Dempsey holding his head.
Shoots the three. short. Oh, nice effort play by Paris right there as he saves it. Youngblood comes away with it, and Ryder's going to have numbers here if they push. Oh. Foul called on Price, trying to guard Youngblood, and he is not happy with that call. He thought he had a clean steal right there.
Paris, foul number zero, Devin.
And we have a timeout on the floor. We'll be right back.
Official timeout.
Welcome back to Alumni Gymnasium, where the score is tied 37-37 between Ryder and Marist, with 7:16 left to go in the game.
And even though that Ryder is not playing that well, they've kept their foul trouble under control tonight, which could be another reason. Them not playing maybe as tough in the paint is why they're losing, or tied actually.
Ryder inbounds the ball from underneath their own basket. Out to Ringel up top the key, swings it to Youngblood. Robinson trying to drive. Swings over Youngblood, over to Thompson. Thompson drives through it. Tough shot, short. Really forcing their shots right now. As Price brings the ball up the court. Swings it to Prescott, who's wide open in the corner. Passes up three. Back out to Price. Marist looks a lot more composed right now than Ryder does.
They look like they have this game under control. Ryder's very confused in the way they've been playing, it looks like. Not really knowing where to go with the ball or who's shooting for them.
Price takes the ball to the hoop. Blocked by Ringel.
Huge block by Mike Ringel there to get some energy into this team.
Robinson trying to go with that. Shoot, pulls up for a jumper, a little short. And Ryder's ball will end up after
and
a fight
like
rebound.
With that block, that gave him a huge spark there. Ryder looked like they knew what they were doing going down the court. Just couldn't get the shot to fall, but it keeps their possession. And let's see if they can make
see
it fall.
Capitalizing this right here. Ooh, dangerous pass. Rusin almost had a steal. Robinson over to Youngblood to Gadsden. Looking inside, nothing. Over to Robinson for three. Looks like he had to cool off sooner or later.
Exactly. Can't make them all.
Price now walks the ball up the court. No one scored now in a couple of minutes. Price hands the ball off to Rusin. Almost loses the ball, hands it off to Prescott. Drives to the lane. A little off on the layup. Ends up in Robinson's hands, who gives it to Thompson. Pushes up the floor to Gadsden. No numbers for Ryder. Takes it to the hole and finishes. Nice move by Gadsden.
Great play by Gadsden. They're going 1-on-5 with Marist and making it fall.
It's a good shot if you make it. Bad shot if you miss. Prescott looking for somewhere to pass to. Finds Price at the top of the key. Directing traffic. Price drives in. Tries the back door with Johnson, but doesn't work. Good defense there by Ringgold. Prescott gets the ball at the wing. Calls out a play. Pick and roll. Nice move by Prescott. Hands it off to Price. That's an NBA three right there. Way off the mark. Prescott with the board and puts it back. Another offensive rebound by Marist.
They're keeping this game close with 5:10 left. It's 39-39. You don't want to let Marist keep getting these shots off. Ryder really needs to start playing some better defense.
The crowd's just waiting for Ryder to make a run so they can explode. But right now, it's just not happening. They really have to try pulling away right here. It's Youngblood with a three. In and out. Ends up in Gadsden's hand. Misses the layup. Misses the second putback. It'll be Ryder's ball.
And when you're that close, you have to make those shots. You got to make those shots fall. Very, very different from what we're used to seeing from Ryder. Is they're always making those little shots, making them closer, making the threes too. But tonight they're just not letting things are just not falling for them. They're just looking very flat, like I've been saying all game.
Looks like they're trying not to lose this game instead of trying to win it. Robinson gets the ball over to Youngblood, back to Robinson, swings it to Gadsden. Drives, nothing there. Pulls the ball out. Swings it to Robinson, top of the key. Over to Thompson on the wing. Ringel, deep corner. Nice ball movement here by Ryder. Youngblood in the paint. good. 2 points.
And good shot by Youngblood there, seeing that the defense was lacking up on him, but then he also got in there, took that nice square up shot rather than taking a very contorted shot.
That was good patience by Ryder on offense. Let's see if they can. And we have an offensive foul on Bauer, setting a screen on Thompson. So let's see if Ryder can extend their lead right here.
Number 41, Corey Bauer, that's his third personal.
There really hasn't been that many substitutions as there were in the first half.
You haven't seen, exactly. From Ryder, you're seeing pretty much the same lineup they started with. You know, trying to stick. I'm surprised we haven't seen more of Jermaine Jackson. He's been a huge, huge defensive force in the past for Ryder. I'd like to, you know, it'd be nice to see them change it up and see if he can get some playing time in there.
Robinson swings it over to Youngblood in the corner. Over to Thompson, skips it to Gadsden, takes it to the hole strong and makes the layup. Nice finish right there by Novar Gadsden.
It looks like Novar Gadsden's been providing that spark Ryder needs to get back into this game. You know, been playing such a versatile role, playing defense on Corey Bauer, who's their center, and playing also as a guard, so he's been playing everywhere, playing the 1 through 5 spots.
Cabo back in the game now for Maris, trying to give them that same spark. Goodwin with the ball. Offensive foul called on Goodwin.
And that's Bauer's fourth foul. It looks like Maris is going to take a timeout. They need to get their composure back.
The foul's on Bauer.
Now, right now, you have to think. You have to try to figure out what Maris is going to do now. You know, they have their big man in foul trouble, with four fouls. You know, do they leave him in or do they take him out? With 3:25 left, do you save him for the last minute to play that defense or do you leave him in? You know, what would you do, Josh?
If I was Chuck Martin right now, I'd leave him in. Right now, it's a four-point game. You don't want this game getting out of hand in the next couple minutes. You leave him in, you tell him to be smart but still play hard.
Exactly.
See what happens.
And if Ryder's smart and if they do leave Bauer in, Ryder needs to take that to their advantage, knowing that he can't play that hard and take the ball and just jam it right where he's at. Try to get as many shots off close to the basket because they know he can't play as hard.
They've been taking a lot of better shots here lately. They've been settling for that deep three there where they've been working the ball in the paint, ending up with shots in the paint, high percentage shots.
Mainly by Gadsden. Gadsden's been really showing up big here in the second half, late in the second half.
Thompson so far, let's see if he's able to step it up right now. I still don't believe he scored any points, which is very rare. I don't know if he's ever gone scoreless before in his Ryder's career.
Exactly, and I totally agree with you there.
So we'll see what happens right now as the crowd is starting to get into it a little bit more, which is always nice to see. Looking at the stat sheet now, Ryan Thompson is 0 for 7 from the field. He does have 3 assists. Besides that, he's been basically a non-factor in this game.
You know, Gadsden coming in with his double-double with 10 points, 11 rebounds, and playing pretty big for Ryder here in the second half as they're starting off kind of cold.
You know, Justin Robinson's been quiet lately. Let's see if they can get him an open shot here. On the floor for Marist is Prescott, Rusin, Carter, Goodwin, and Acaba. For Ryder, Thompson, Youngblood, Ringgold, Gadsden, and Robinson. Ryder set to inbound the ball. And Marist is back in the 2-3 zone, which has baffled Ryder. And they've only gotten a total of 43 points right now with a little over 3 minutes left in the game.
And it's interesting to see Ryder staying with the same starting lineup. They've had them in for a good 17 minutes now. It looks like they're not that tired. They're more just baffled by the play style they've been playing by today.
Robinson gets the ball, swings it over to Youngblood on the near side. Drives the hoop over to Thompson. 4-3, in and out. Oh, he thought he
Thompson
had that
shaking
one.
His head, just not having a good game today, going 0 for
Very
8 so far with 0 points.
That would have been a huge 3 if he was able to connect on that.
I think he just needs a shot like that just to get him started up.
Kava takes the ball to the hole. And we have an offensive foul on Kava. Ringgold stood in and took that charge. Nice play right there,
good
by Ringgold.
Good defensive awareness there by Mike Ringgold. Seeing the play, knowing to plant his feet and stay like that, rewarding the team on the defensive end.
Gadsden set the inbound the ball to Thompson. 2:46 left now, and the score is 43-39. Bronx are ahead. Let's see what they do here on offense. Thompson brings the ball up, guarded by Rusin. Dribbles to the far side. Over to Robinson, swings the Youngblood. Youngblood wide open, did not take the shot though. No one looks like they want to take a shot right now.
It looks like Ryan Thompson.
Nice passing right there. Youngblood finishes underneath. Nice pass by Ringgold. Good ball movement.
That's Youngblood's 9th point of the game. Playing a very pivotal role here as a good role player for Ryder's offense.
Prescott looking for someone to pass to. Finds Caba on the near side. Hands it off to Prescott. Thinks about shooting it. Drives to his right. We have a foul on Robinson, who is not happy with the call, as he argues with the ref.
Again, that's Robinson's 4th foul, it looks like. You know, it's has to be very careful with his fouls, because it's been a huge problem for Ryder in the past, and they don't want to see that happen again, where they're in foul trouble and they have to make these hard decisions whether to leave a guy in.
So Ryder's in that 2-3 zone again as Maris is inbounding underneath. Prescott for 3. Long on the shot. Good box out there by Gadsden as he gathers the rebound.
Gadsden's 12th rebound. Playing some huge skills off the boards tonight.
Ryder looks like they're content to kill some clock right here. It's 1:45 left in the game, and they have a 6-point lead. Gadsden takes it strong into the hole and gets fouled. He'll be shooting too.
And right now, I think Ryder's more just trying to salvage their lead, keep their lead, rather than trying to put more points up on the board, trying to get those stats up. I think Ryder's just very tired, and they just want to get out of this game with a win and not take the risk of losing to a team like Marist that's 0-5 right now.
Gadsden's first free throw is good. Maris now has 19 fouls. Ryder will be in the double bonus now for the rest of the game. That's very important if Maris chooses to foul Ryder in the next minute or so. Gadsden's second free throw is also good.
Gadsden playing some huge, huge role in the second half with 12 points, 12 rebounds. Playing really very solid, very, very solid.
Maris is going to have to make a run right here if they want to get back in this game in the next minute, 30 seconds. Caba gets the ball, thinks about shooting it, takes Ringgold to the hoop, looks to pass. Oh, we have a foul called on the floor.
Very Ryder sloppy foul there by Jamar happy. Youngblood. That's his 4th foul. And they only have a 1:30 left, or 1:25 left here, so I'm not surprised to see them leave Youngblood in just because he's a very good player, but for the time being, that he needs to play smart.
Ryder still has one more foul to give before Maris will be the 1-1 bonus. Goodwin gets the ball at the top of the key. Maris is going to have to hurry. They're down 8 here with 1:20 left. They seem to be in no rush, though. A lot of miscommunication going on here for Maris. As Goodwin forces the ball in with the jumper, good. We have a timeout by Maris as Chuck Martin wants to talk about the strategy for the last minute.
And that's Goodwin's only 4th point tonight. I'm surprised to see not as much offensive production from Goodwin tonight.
Yeah, he had a season-high 18 points last game. Maris lost. And we'll be right back.
Hey, Mike. What are your expectations going into tonight's game?
Just to play hard and just get a W. Start the MAC conference off right, 1-0.
What do you think your role is going to be in tonight's game, and what are you trying to do to win this game?
My role is pretty much the same every game. Just go in and play hard, make energy plays, and score the ball when I can, play defense, and bring that leadership to me.
What'd you guys do preparing to go into the MAC conference?
Nothing really, just coming to practice, like practicing hard, diving on loose balls, taking charges and stuff like that.
And we're back as there are 1:07 left in the game with Ryder up 6 points and the ball. And they look down to Gadsden, and oh no, ball goes out of bounds. That's an errant pass right there by Mike Ringgold. That's a gutsy call right there.
Yeah, I think that they really need to go to a better spread offense here to try to get their man open rather than just kind of heaving it up there, hoping that he's going to catch it. You know, it's very iffy to do that.
They went for the football pass right there, try to get the easy layup. And so now Maris can make this a one-possession game with a 3 right here. Let's see what they do. Goodwin has the ball at the top of the key. Over to Prescott, who has Ringgold on him. Takes it to the hoop. Oh, thrown away by Ringgold. Nice block.
Huge block by Ringgold there. Getting some defensive energy into this game for Ryder, showing up. He's been showing up really big late in the second half here.
Okay, Marist in on the ball from underneath. Having some trouble getting it in. Has to call a timeout. Good defense right there by Ryder.
If you're Maris, you don't want to call that timeout, but you kind of have to. You can't afford to get a turnover here with 52 seconds left. So it was a very good vision there by Goodwin to call the timeout. But at the same time, you don't want to waste timeout. So it's a bittersweet decision.
It looks
there.
Like Bauer is coming back into the game. It looks like the coach did save him for the last minute. And they ended up down 6. So there's a coaching move right there that could be criticized.
But it'll be interesting to see how he plays with it, with being such a dominant force in the defensive paint area. It'll be interesting to see how this works out in their favor. Also, when they're shooting those threes, which I'm sure they're going to be throwing up a lot of threes, being they're only down by 6, see how many rebounds he can get.
You know, it'll be interesting to see if they choose to do the hacky shack method with Ringgold. If he gets the ball, that would not be a bad method for a coach.
And that might be what they're going to do, but I'd assume that Ringgold would probably be inbounding it just because of Ryder knowing that fact that they'd probably try to do that.
And the rest of their team are all excellent free throw shooters. Everyone except Jamar Youngblood is over 70%. They get the ball and Goodwin has it up top. There's now 47 seconds left. Takes it to the hole. Nice finish right there by Goodwin. And another timeout by Maris as they're trying to gather their composure and try to find a way to win this game. And we'll be right back. Welcome back to what looks like to be an exciting finish here in Alumni Gymnasium with the Ryder Bronx leading the Marist Red Foxes 47-43 with 45 seconds left.
It'll be Mike Ringgold inbounding the ball. It'll be interesting to see what approach they take here. I think that the Gadsden would just pull up real quick to give him the ball.
Inbounds the ball, Youngblood in the corner, and he's immediately fouled by Russo.
Smart play call here by Maris, fouling quickly. In the last game against St. Joe's, it was a similar situation towards the end, but St. Joe's waited too long to foul, and it just didn't work out well for them. But it's good to see that Maris is being smart with their fouls, fouling quickly, getting Ryder to the line to try to get their time back.
Youngblood's at the line shooting too. He's a 73% free throw shooter. And he misses the first one. This could be very critical down the line, the free throws.
There's a lot of pressure on Youngblood right now to make this shot, because right now it's a 4-point game, which could easily become a Marist lead if they can get a 3-pointer and another basket. So huge pressure on Youngblood here. Let's see if he can pull through.
And the second free throw from Youngblood is good off the front rim and in. Nice bounce right there for Youngblood.
Very, very good bounce there. He looked like he was on his heels there when he saw that going down.
Goodwin brings the ball up the floor. Marist needs to hurry right here. Probably going to look for a three. Prescott opening the corner for three. Oh, and it's good.
Huge three-pointer for Marist.
Game now here in Alumni Gymnasium.
And the whole Marist bench is all on their feet right now. Very, very big energy booster for them. And Robinson and Gadsden were just talking to each other, trying to find out what happened wrong there, trying to analyze the play. So very, very, very big three for Marist.
Coming up right now, Ringgold's probably going to be inbounding the ball again. It's going to be very crucial, not only to make the free throws, but just get the ball in general. A lot of times you see teams throw it away, and that would be terrible right now, because right now Marist has all the momentum in the world.
Totally agree with you there. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens here. Ryder needs to get this ball in. It's a must. If they don't get this ball in, the kind of energy that Marist is going off right now, almost guarantees them to get that close basket in there. They mess up on the inbounding play. So a lot of pressure on whoever's inbounding the ball here. Now, I'd assume so that it'd be Mike Ringel, but you never know. They might give it to someone else to go try to do a different type of deep throw or something like that, putting their best free throw shooters out there.
And the person they want on the line is Justin Robinson. He's an 89% free throw shooter on the year. So you know they really want to get it in his hands. That or Ryan Thompson, who's also a 77% free throw shooter.
Which, it's a huge point. Anytime you're playing basketball close this late in the game, you want to get it to your best free throw shooter. So Marist knows that. Marist knows who's their free throw shooters, and they're going to be double covering Justin Robinson, if I had to guess.
Interesting to see, Ringgold is not inbounding the ball. It'll be Gadsden. So you know if Ringgold gets the ball in his hands, Marist will have to foul him immediately. Sure enough, a foul is called on Goodwin, and lucky for Ryder, Justin Robinson will be going to the line for two.
And that is perfect situation for Ryder right now. Let's see if Justin Robinson can pull through here. He needs to make one to keep it at a one-possession game at least.
Still plenty of time on the clock with 32 seconds left.
Which is a lifetime in basketball, as I'm sure a lot of people know.
The first free throw is good by Robinson.
The pressure not getting to Robinson there.
As Johnson comes in for Marist.
That's Robinson's 15th point in the night, leading Ryder.
He's been quiet, though, late in the second half. These are his first points in a while. Second free throw is also good. Two big free throws there by Justin Robinson. Cabba gets the ball on the wing. Drives to the hoop. Forces up a shot. Ooh, foul call.
That is a very controversial call on Mike Ringgold there. Looked like he had his hands straight up. Didn't look like he went into him at all. And the crowd very upset about that call.
Cabo will go to the line and shoot two to try to make this a two-point game once again.
And Cabo's been their huge player tonight for Marist. So let's see if he continues to be their go-to guy here and see if he can sink these free throws.
Very big free throws here. No good is the first one. Looks like
looks like the pressure got to him.
That one rimmed in and out.
And I think that if Marist wants to stay in this game, they have to sink this shot right here. If they don't make it, then it's just going to keep going from there.
And he misses both of them. But Marist, another offensive rebound and a three. Oh, it's good. It's now a one-point game with 22 seconds left. And now the ball's loose. Youngblood has it and is fouled. What a series of events.
Huge. That's what we've been saying all game. You cannot let Marist get the offensive rebounds there. And you've seen how detrimental that has been. Instead of getting 2 points, they got that three-pointer. It's a one-point game.
Tommy
all the
Dempsey's
pressure on Young.
Right now.
Exactly. Tommy Dempsey is looking very angry. And even though Youngblood's at the line, he's been having some trouble tonight late in the second half. A lot of pressure shots on him.
No matter what now, Marist will get a chance to either take the lead or tie the game. The first free throw is good by Youngblood. This is a big one right here.
Huge one. This makes the difference between a winning shot Marist has a shot at or a tying shot.
Still 20 seconds left on the clock. The second one is also good. We have a substitution. Mike Ringgold comes in for Brandon Penn.
And right now, I think they're going to go to Cabba for that three or Goodwin. Goodwin's been quiet in the first half, but really coming through big for Marist right in the second half here.
3-point game with 20 seconds left as Goodwin gets the ball, comes up the court, hands it off to Cabba. Cabba goes to the hoop, puts it up, and in. 12 seconds left on the clock now.
1-point game here.
And there's a foul before they get inbound called on Prescott.
It looks like Ryan Thompson will have a chance to get his first points of the night here. It's been very cold. Maybe not a bad foul by Marist. Even though he's a 79% three-throw shooter, maybe not the worst foul because he's been cold tonight, shooting not good from the field. He's gone 0 for 8. from the field. So let's see what Thompson does. Can he perform under this pressure?
A one-point game now, I'm sorry. 52-51, 12 and a half seconds left in the Alumni Gymnasium. The first free throw. Short.
Ooh, and Thompson
will have a chance to either tie or win, whatever they choose. Thompson is really upset with himself right now, shaking his head. He needs to concentrate and make this free throw. Makes the second. It's now a two-point game with 12 seconds left. Ball's inbounded to Goodwin. 10 seconds left. Brings it up the court. Hands it off to Cabo. Pulls for a fadeaway jumper. Short. Robinson with the rebound. 3 seconds left and is fouled.
And a huge miss by their go-to guy tonight, Cabo. Cabo's looking at himself very upset.
That was a poor shot selection right there by Maris. When they only had
just couldn't get it to fall. You know, the whole team is staring at that basket. Even though Ryder has a chance to keep pushing this lead higher, they have the man they want on the free throw line right now.
He can ice this game right now with these two free throws if he makes both.
And Justin Robinson needs to perform under this pressure, which he's done all night very well.
Makes the first one. This is the biggie right here.
This is the difference between giving Marist comeback a shot or not.
And he makes it. It's now 55-51 Ryder. And the last heave by Rusin is no good.
Ryder
now score here at Alumni Gymnasium. Ryder 55, Marist 51.
And we'll be right back with our post-game wrap-up show.
Welcome to the post-game wrap-up here in Alumni Gymnasium. I'm Josh Felchery here with Matt Blum. The Ryder Bronx just pulled off a nail-biting win against the Marist Red Foxes, 55-51. What were the factors to the win for Ryder?
Yeah, there's a lot of factors for Ryder. I mean, it was just making their shots, which weren't falling, to be honest, but they made the shots late in the game that they needed to come out with the win. And, you know, in the post-game press conference with Coach Dempsey, said we just didn't play well tonight. And, you know, it does reflect that, you know, 55-51 win, when you're usually seeing Ryder win by a lot more. You know, a huge key for Marist staying in the game was their zone defense. I think the zone defense threw Ryder off. They were expecting it, being that, you know, Binghamton played the same type of zone defense, and it was a similar close game. But, you know, that matching up with Ryan Thompson not really making his shots, only having 1 point in the game, also a lot of guys are struggling. Justin Robinson, the only player really playing out to, you know, normal form with 18 points. But for the most part, it's really, I think, just about letting this win, you know, stay where it is and going to the next game against LaSalle on Wednesday, you know, keeping, you know, in mind that not every game is going to be a blowout.
Yeah, it was really big for Ryder to get their first conference win, improving the record to 6-3 overall. Like you said, they play LaSalle on Wednesday before going on the road until January 9th against Iona. So I guess we'll see just how they do.
Exactly. I think it's going to be a huge part. How they play against LaSalle is going to set up, because they've had a lot of home games. Most of their games have been home games. And I think how they play against LaSalle will set them up for their road trip for, like you said, till January 9th. So I guess we'll definitely have to see how that happens. You know, not a great game from either team tonight, but Ryder coming out with a win.
From everyone here at the Ryder University Network, we'll see you next time.